Section 3. At the end of this section, you should be able to discuss timber conversion. In this segment of the video, we will look at how the log is being converted to timber so it can be used with ease. The log is taken to the sawmill by a truck to be converted into smaller pieces that can be handled in the woodwork shop. There are many forms of sawmills being developed now, but to categorize these, we have two main types: the band saw sawmill and the table saw sawmill. At the sawmill, the following safety measures are to be considered. Safety gears and tips. Before you start this task, ensure the following. 1. Put on eye protection. 2. Wear safety gloves. 3. Use safety shoes and hard boots. 4. Ear protection. Steps in timber conversion. 1. Take the log from the truck and rest it on the saw table. 2. Position the wood as necessary to feed the machine and clamp the log where appropriate. This is so that it can give a neat cut. Avoid blade twisting and kickbacks. 3. Allow the machine to feed the log automatically to make the cuts. There are sawmills that will allow the workers to feed the wood to the machine manually, but there are many others with improved technologies which automatically feed the wood. 4. Rotate the wood in a different position to cut until it looks semi-square or square. This is called a cant. 5. Continue to rotate the wood until the final cut. At the sawmill, the log can be converted by 1. Through and through, or plane or crown saw, which produces tangential boards. 2. The quarter saw is a far more expensive cut because of the more steps involved. Common sizes of converted logs. Balk. A balk has a cross section of at least 115 millimeters by 100 millimeters. It can be used in the form of heavy structural work such as a beam or a column. Half timber. This is one half of a balk that has been cut longitudinally. A half timber is mainly used for structural work. It may, however, be further cut into marketable sizes. Plank. Timber having a size of between 50 millimeter to 150 millimeter thickness and a width of at least 300 millimeter. Generally used for supporting loads on scaffolds and also used on its edge for supporting deep joists and ceiling hangers. Deal. The term used for softwoods of width between 250 mm and 280 mm and thickness ranging from 50 mm to 100 mm. Batten. Timber cut to a thickness ranging from 50 mm to 100 mm and width of between 100 mm and 200 mm. Batten are mostly cut from softwood and used for holding roof covering and ceiling framings. Board. A piece of timber with a thickness less than 50 mm and a width of 100 mm or more. Boards are used in the construction industry for flooring, shelving, and furniture making. Scantling. Timber having thickness ranging from 50 mm to 100 mm and width varying from 50 mm to 115 mm. These are used for smaller beams and frames, such as rafters for roofs, wall studs, and floor joists. Strips. These are pieces of timber less than 50 mm thick and less than 100 mm wide.